Welcome to my series for Car Mechanic Simulator 2015. For those of you watching on YouTube, don't forget to check the description in the video for a link to my Car Mechanic Simulator 2015 guide, where you'll find complete rebuilds of all the cars, along with extra videos, tips and tricks, and a whole bunch of extra information including diagnostics, etc. In this video, we're going to do a complete rebuild of the Katagiri Katsumoto. As you can tell, this car is in pretty bad shape. Let's just take a quick look at how bad. Not much on this car is worth saving. And when doing a restoration, if it's not mint, you really take a hit on the sale price, so you want the car in mint condition. So let's stick it on the lifter and strip the junk. I like to start with the body because when the car looks like absolute garbage, it's depressing to work on. And I don't think there's any body left to take off. I think that's all of it. And we'll try to repair this stuff. Well, something just broke and that was no doubt expensive. Sell that off. Okay, so left headlight, left door, right door, Katsu, and I might as well just grab those right now. Oh, and I need a left headlight. And what will I need here? Left taillight. Right taillight. And the body is now at 100%. I'll just move it to the paint shop. And that looks a lot better. Stick it back on the lifter and basically nothing on this car is any good, so well, except for the new body. Sorry if I'm misclicking a little, I'm not used to rebuilding this particular model. It's just not very profitable compared to some of the other cars. It's still profitable, especially if you get it in really poor condition. Actually, the worse the condition of the car, the better off you are, because you're gonna pay more for a higher quality car, and that means you're paying more for parts that you'll very possibly fail to repair and end up not using. And while you can sell them, it's not as good as if you just end up with a bunch of junk that you paid almost nothing for. Oh, come on, get a grip. And I'm gonna start paying more attention. I'm used to rebuilding certain models, and they go in a dramatically different order. Get all these little bushings here. And here's where it actually starts to get silly, because you actually unbuild the engine in the car instead of pulling it out and putting it on an engine stand. Although for some reason in the loading graphics they show you with it on an engine stand, or at least being hoisted out, yet in practice in game you just rebuild it in the body, which is just ridiculous. And now it's time to go under and yank off that gearbox and drain the oil. My oil buddy's in my way. And that should about do it. get this thing out of my way. Might as well pull the exhaust while I'm here. It's all gotta go anyway. This camera's a little annoying at times, but not too bad. Rebuilding these is actually a lot of fun, and it's much easier than the diagnostics side. Not to mention it's a lot more profitable. And you do not actually, I believe, need parking to go to the auction house and buy cars. You just need cash and space in your garage to move them around. However, you will want to wait until your repair skill is up. Although, if you buy a low enough quality vehicle, you can still make a profit buying all new parts. It also helps to have the fast unbolt and the fast disassembly. And the fuel tanks, they never recover. There's a few parts like pistons, the fuel tank, crankshaft pulley, they never recover, so you're guaranteed you have to get new ones. By all rights, this car is quite close to being completely stripped. Now for the gearbox. I might as well take that while I'm here. That's about everything. No? Yeah. And now up and down again. And let's see what does and does not survive. A lot of garbage. And all this power clicking, if you have arthritis, tendonitis, carpal tunnel, this game will kill you for it. The repairing and selling is brutal. Of course, I gotta sell the junk. And substandard parts gotta go too. There's $1,000 in brake parts right there that survived. Wow, do I have calipers? So let's see what didn't survive. At least that did. Power steering didn't. Filters never do. I think I actually zipped past the power steering pump. There we go. Anything else I need right away? That never does. I forgot the fuel filter. Now, until I throw the crank in, I can't rebuild any more of the engine. Front exhaust section. Ooh, lost the head. Take a battery while I'm at it. lost the air filter base. Normally those recover pretty well. Brake servos usually recover as well. And I'm short one camshaft. I find normally those recover as well. Okay, yeah, air filter base is gone. Cam gears. Fuel rail made it. Intake manifold. So, intake manifold, cam gears, filter base. That tablet for buying parts on the fly is a lifesaver, because unless you can memorize the entire parts list and not forget, you'll run a lot to your bench. So it's just so much easier to have that and just be able to pop in and out. I'm hoping I bought spark plugs. Spark plugs are just good for garbage, they never recover. And ignition coils. I need a timing belt. Ignition coils, where do they live now? Oh, right there. And I don't need that crank gear I picked up, but it will go on another build. And all those ABS parts did recover nicely. And I still forgot to get a fuel filter. Okay, air filter cover. There we go. That's run over here and do the clips. They're so easy to forget. Timing covers, I find, usually recover. Oh, yeah, I did need that crank pulley after all. Water pumps are pretty good at recovering. Belts never. Serpentine A. Belt tensioner. Serpentine A. Apparently I do actually have a lot of those in stock. And that's almost the entire engine rebuilt. Now, if I can just avoid forgetting to put oil on this when I'm done, I'll be good. And I need a bunch of bushings. They're dirt cheap, so it's always good to have some in stock. I find the steering racks usually recover tie rods, sway bar, never, almost never. I'll need one of those, I'm not sure which one. Okay, rear. Let's get up to the front. Oops. Two of those. If you get into rebuilding cars, buying some extra parts here and there, even if you buy the wrong ones, it doesn't matter because you're going to need them on one of your rebuilds sooner or later anyway. Unless you constantly buy the wrong one and you end up with like 50 or 60 of something you don't use often. And I'll need a bunch of brake parts. The knuckles usually do recover, and I find the suspension arms often recover. Springs and caps pretty much never. Actually, no, that is a definite never, springs and caps. Okay, so let's get the brake parts. Two ventilated, two pads, and I have a mountain of calipers. Those recover well. It really does look nice and shiny new now. Let's get this put together. Flywheels never. Clutch plates sometimes recover. I don't think the covers usually do. The pressure plates, pardon me. Those release bearings, I don't think they recover, or at least they certainly don't recover often. I'm always buying them. Drive axles are pretty good for recovery. Front springs and covers. And I think it's the standard front shock absorber. Do I need the cap? Yes, good. As for those sway links, I don't think they recover. I think I just have a mountain of them because I never remember which one, so I just buy both. They're dirt cheap and you go through an awful lot of them anyway. Looks like I lost two of the rims. And of course, most of the exhaust system is just no dice. Catalytic converter, middle muffler, exhaust pipe. Okay, it's got one of those. Okay, so yeah, I'll just get the fuel tank now. Lost the rear suspension cross member. I didn't even buy enough bushings. Now I got extra in stock. Rear sway A. I don't think those recover either, I just had a spare in stock. Good thing I bought the extra bushings. Huh, wheel cap, brake disc. And another bushing. Rear shock A. Rear sway link. I'll need a pair of those. Might as well get extras. Classic Rim 2. Have I missed anything? Yes. And I think that's everything for there. Okay. Suspension arm I'm missing. I'm missing one little teeny part. Starter. Now I gotta put that on from under the hood. And I couldn't put that on without the gearbox. Okay, so I think all I need now is some engine oil. I think I only paid about $10,000, maybe $8,000 for this car. I'll put a little image over the end of the video that shows what I paid for it, and you'll see what I'm selling it for. I also put in a tally of how much the repairs cost. It's looking nice. Now to get rid of it and get some cash in the bank. And if you try to sell it and it's not complete, it will certainly let you know. As a reminder for those of you watching on YouTube, don't forget to check the video description for links to my Car Mechanic Simulator 2015 guide. Hope you've enjoyed the video and hope to catch you again soon.